Okay, that would help. All right, so trying to figure out what to do next. Okay, so I'm gonna make a subclass of pain manager. I'm called this. What I want to do is have in these panes a list of things that you can buy. Each individual item or stock up on, however we want to look at that. And then I have like another pane at the top, which is say kind of an overall. You just look up and see your stats. So you're building your ship to be put into the game. So let's see what we got here. This is so let's just get it so we can buy stuff. Do that and I have another four windows here that I work on, but for the most part, this is good. All right, so what can we do here? Angles. Angle. Oh, excuse me. So what we need to do is create a, just trying to figure out how to do an easy new subclass. I think I'll just stick to the nice basic method, which of course is just add a class. We'll call this one by disks. Basically, just do very similar stuff. Now, pane manager looks for all the sub panes. In this case, we'll also make the panes be a subclass called command disk pane, and we'll fill out those details in a moment. So, right now, the pane manager, his job is to basically get a list and do that animation. Not really anything past that. And the difference is I'm going to instantiate out all the panes I need before I do the superclass. So I'm going to do the super. I'm not on mind blank tonight. C# base, that's right. Base. Oh, I can't do that. All right, you have to do the public, right? Public doesn't help. No. Oh, it's because the parent is not a public. Imagine. All right, now it's complaining. They're not doing anything. Oh, yeah, wait, too much. Let me just do that. I don't really have to. Oh, well. Alright, so instantiate all the subpanes based on going to do is we're going to have a group of command disks. I'm going to just make one for now in each of these panes. We have, let's see here. We have,
but that attempt.
What we're going to do is we're gonna... Okay. We have, let's see here. So each pane is going to have a command disk. And then our resources, we have some command disks. So way to go. Fabs. So these are the command disks. So each of these is a different disk. Number and whatnot. They have some scripts on them. Actually, you might be able to use that. I didn't think about it. Actually, very good. It puts the number on that command disk, so we may just use that guy as is. So what I'm going to do is just create a quick list of command disks. Command disk. Command disk. Disks. Training. Okay. So we're going to just do for each disk. I will create a. Oh, excuse me. We're going to instantiate a pane for each of these. So for the moment, I'm going to just instantiate a pane at this place. So, okay. So I'm going to have to do instantiate an object, which is going to be our prefab, which in this case is. Interesting question. It's an object. It's plain old objects. Whatever that object is, we can do a disk. We can instantiate that object. Actually, what we need is a pane, so let me get a prefab on this thing. To go to game objects. And actually, let's just kind of do, let's do this in a roundabout way. So we're going to do prefab. Okay. Whatever pane we want, we're going to do prefab pane. And believe it or not, I'm going to just put it on this because it's flying. Yes, it's technically default, but just in case there's any doubt. And instantiate a bunch of prefab panes. And then we're going to do the rest of the stuff. Basically, this is create a command disk pane. Create a pane and command disk. Right. This is a list of disks in there. Okay.
If we go back over here now. Ooh.
Hey, I'm sorry. I'm tired. Okay, so we have the regular pane manager here. And he got filled with. Oh, we're still running. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to add the subclass of my command disks. Okay, I'm going to get rid of this pane manager. He goes away. Okay, so he's going to look for all the subpanes in the scene. But lo and behold, we need a pane prefab. I have not made one. Put that under UI and create a subfolder called. No shelf stuff folder. Alright, we're gonna put this pane in here, boom, we're done with that. We actually don't need these other ones, they can go away. In fact, this guy's good. Just get rid of him. He's gone. So all I got is these floating arrows, and then in theory, this guy will be able to take the pane. Prefab. I guess I'm gonna inspect over here. I need to basically make this pane. This is, I've got a command disk object here, it's invisible. It's going to generate a prefab per type of disk. Now we only have one type so far. But we have several. So I'm going to do extractor. Boom. I'm going to do laser turret. I guess I could just select all of these. And we'll have more later, but I just lost everything as usual. And this launcher I did. Alright, fine. Does it show up? Alright, on my line. Actually, I can block it. Put that over there. Drop them in, boom. There's all seven of them. And somewhere in them. Alright. So, should have seven panes appear. Right now, I'm going to just see that there's seven. If that worked correctly, regardless of the contents of these panes, it should do something. Okay. Oh. See one. So the three of them, of course, we're going to get. We seem to have a problem with moving, though. And it may be because, I don't know, did I lose my left right arrow? I did. Okay. Sure, surprise. Rotate left. Huh. Alright, mental note. Lose connections and new subclass with another object.
Okay, well, it makes sense because we're going to the subclass, not to the parent class.
I would have thought that. I would have thought it was not to me, but that's okay. Six, seven, and then they start rotating. I still gotta fix that other body, but there we go. There's seven of them. Alright, so we've created seven. And the reason I'm not doing that bug is I want to actually kind of attach the command disks into these views so I can see what's happening over there. Alright, so as a first go run, I'm going to take my pane and go to my prefab and actually just drop one in. For testing. Boom. Okay. And it's not because I really want to, I'm just kind of curious what would happen. Alright, so if we go to one of our command disks, we should be able to just drop it into this pane, and there it is. Okay, so, wow. Really? Is that the actual locations on these things? Huh. I'm gonna have to have a word with some other code. That's really bizarre. Alright, well, we drop that pane. Let's see here. If we go to the after the translate, let's see. Way behind, so let's. I thought it would. I wonder if it's done. Let's do it. Yeah, that's what I thought. So the center of all these panes are way over here. So my positions are nuts. Okay. So if I do put this guy Translated. Translated just means it's been pushed out. And then of course I zero out all these guys. Don't worry about rotation or anything like that. That's probably done. So you can see it nicely puts in the middle. Yeah. I want to make these things bigger. Let's say 2x2x2. Certainly I could just make prefabs for all this. I'm about to do that. I like magic code. This is again where prefabs of prefabs can be kind of nice. Alright, well, I'll get a little further. By the way, is that as dark as that looks? Is it really light as that's gone? That's a problem. Well, what has happened is I calculated all the light in this place and pre-rendered it, and I used basically only the emission lights. So I need a light source. So I guess we're going to have to use directional light and do something with that. Or I can try to fiddle with it more. I almost tempted to do a point light. Let's see, one other thing. Mesh renderer in here. I've got shadows turned off on it, I think. Mesh, these were a bunch of little meshes. Receive shadows, catch shadow, no. Light map static. I'm curious now, if I turn on the light map static, it's going to have to calculate that for that location. I'm not a fan of that, so I'm going to turn that off. What I think I will do is I will do some lighting. I'll go ahead for a moment. I'll make a point light. I'm just going to set it in the area. We can actually put it in our PUI. And then maybe zero it out a bit. Let's make it range time. Actually, no, let's do real time light. That's a good idea. Yeah. No, you're not receiving any of that light. I know you're within 30. It's right there. I'll shove it down closer to it. Wow. This guy is not receiving any of that light. What do we do with this light? Really? If we turn this on, does it like blind us now? I mean, really? Nothing. I mean, black is black. Yay. Alright. Well, I have not been messing with lighting much, so we're going to just go in the direction of light for now. I'm going to turn on the lights. I'll figure out something about that. Oh my gosh. Yeah. And now the lighting works. Really? Did I have that turned off the whole time? Wow. That's actually kind of impressive. That's really quite bright. Jeez. Wow. We can use that. That's kind of cool. All right. I'm mentally storing that one. What do you say, anti-chamber? That's kind of cool. The funny thing is, it's still kind of black. Alright, let's see here. Where is this last point again? It's because I'm on the back side, yeah. So that's on the back side, we're going to the front side. Alright, let's kind of chill here, guys. I just want a little bit of light. A little bit of light. Maybe a little more than that. I'm actually probably going to use a hologram graphic shader I have. Just haven't done it yet. So this is semi-temporary. I guess the only problem is as soon as this thing goes away to the right or left, it's going to disappear. So alright. Well, tell you what, I'll put them back at the center. It goes not in the pane, but in the manager. This position is middle. And for now, oh, wow. That's some interesting lighting there. I've got to play with this. All right. So the pane, of course, is not really there in the extractor. We've already determined we're going to zero the position, we're going to double the scale. Let's just play with it a little bit here. I'm not sure how long I have to keep it. So let's say pane. Let's create a function called. I want to make a subclass out of this. I do. Because I want these panes to be kind of really generic. So let's do that. Save it as a pane command disk. By command disk. By command disk. And that goes actually in our release. I'm using the pile. Okay. And this is actually then a pane. And it is the by command disk pane. So I should, okay. And of course we need to, let's go right here. Can be found. Should be there. Some reason I think I need to generate a new type. We have a pane. That we did. I don't know that that is going to be. Okay. Why is it having a problem with that? This campaign manager is because all the other scripts have pain. Is going to complain. Pain. It's okay. Still thinking. There's. It's just an old message. Alright, so if instead of pain, lighting. Okay, if I instead of pain, I have to the pain, I have down here. Instead of pain, I have other script. Well, that's interesting. Oh, well, that's because I'm being kind of stupid here. I haven't done all this yet, so we'll leave all that. Okay, all that. Alright, so we're just a subclass. Boom, boom. Oh, and easier through for doing that. Okay, so now, go back to Unity, let it compile, It should change and go away. Right. So now we can get rid of this guy. And this is a little different because this is a different pain. You think about this. Let's break this object. Let's break this object. I'm gonna make a new prefab. I'm gonna call this. I'm going to buy a command pane. So we need this, or that component. And then take this buy command pane and put this in a prefab UI start directory. There. Okay. And, excuse me. This is our prefab now for the pane UI. Checking out push name. Okay. Now instead of our standard, we're going to do a command pane. Okay. So just to make sure we haven't totally broke it, we got 5 errors down here. What's going on here? Oh, it is working. Okay. We see 1, 2, 3, so already I'm pretty confident. We got about 7 of those. Yeah, we're good. Okay, so I didn't totally break it. So the next thing we need to do is, so I got 7 of them, now I'm going to put the actual command disk in. I got a list there, so it's real simple. Each of these command panes now have a script on them, which can now accept a command, such as void. Actually, let's do this. I'm gonna set up. Big deal. Except what we do is we take the command. Just set command. So command disk comes in. It's got disk. This is actually a little more complex than it looks because what we want to do is what I'm being fast in is really a prefab, so I'm going to instantiate it. I'm going to instantiate Mr. D and call disk that. And then, as we said, we wanted to make a few changes to this local position. Sorry, transform. And that needs to be put into the, let me decide, parent. No. I think that's wrong because we're going to need a reference to where to put it underneath. And so, believe it or not, that's going to be, we'll just do that. We'll do that. Do a public transform. It's called pane position. Alright, so the pane position is after where the translate occurs. So command disk will then have. I'm not ready for that. Okay, so transform local position equals vector t. Okay. Zero out of numbers. And then also just transform two. Okay. And as we saw, that makes it about the right size. So we still got a call command disk. Before we get too far, let's get the reference to the internal logic, which I could have done another way. I'm kind of a big fan of doing it this way. Let's see a semicolon. What did I do? Is that semicolon? Is it just dual? Looks like that's just dual. Alright. So the pane position is this guy. Now apply that. So any instantiated panes will appear with individual objects. Pop. With references to the translator. So now we know where, at what point we can instantiate it in that object. Okay. We won't have to worry about rotation because it will always be in reference to the display, and all the models are set to be is negative z is the front. At least the prefabs, I should say. So. Next up, so it should instantiate. So all we're going to do is in the manager, tell it to set the command disk on each of these. Please go to the, for each of these instantiate. We'll call that a by command disk. Oops, I'm wrong. No, you're the right thing. What's that? Object instantiate. Do that. Yeah. Clone as widget body. That's what it's supposed to be. I'm not complaining. I cannot convert game object. So my prefab pane. Did this before. Really? You know what? Yeah, that's fine. We can do it this way. We know it needs to be a particular type, so. That'll ensure our classes are okay. I mean, it's a game object, it's going to still instantiate the whole game object. And the pane will appear. Alright, so that allows us then to call we can call that function, which is set. Command disk. Oh, I didn't make it up. There we go. Command disk. Could have done an equal and get her. Call me lazy. Okay. So it's command disk, which will then instantiate it, put it in there, and off we go. Alright. In theory, I can leave my example here, and unless it reactivates it. Okay, here we go. Let's see here. Ooh, nothing, of course. Alright. Any errors? Yes. An object you want to instantiate is null, which of course probably means Since I changed the type, it lost me. So, let me guess, because I went from game object to... Yeah, I lost my prefab. Okay, no prefab, no problem. It does have to match, I'll get that. Why it can't do a little work for us, just a little bit, be nice. Okay. There we go again. Ah, I got windows. I don't have objects. Ah, I got windows here. It tells me the light is all under 5. Okay, which tells me they're rotating, but they're somehow in the wrong place. Some of them up here. So they are subclasses that I don't even have to look at them. I just know that their position is wrong because they got put not they got put inside the pane, not the translated location, which basically yeah. Okay, it's because I didn't put it in the instantiated, I put in the transform, not in the pane position transform. There you go. That should do it. Let's see if the lighting works. I doubt it. It doesn't look like it would be too happy. Hey, wait a minute. What happened to my lighting? Did I do something? I didn't save it. Alright. Well, that doesn't look too bad. Here's the package. Okay. So here we are. Item 1. Item 2. Our store is working. We can do some special effects. Move around. It is kind of weird. It's going through my hand as I choose these. I can move the buttons down or something like that. I'm not sure yet. It's a shield. We put some text, cost, buy, buy, sell, sell. That's my ultimate goal. Right. And these are, these are my interfaces. It's a little dark in here, but we'll work. Sometimes I wish you could just say, hey, what's the ambient light on your object? And then, instead of this, it's actually kind of cool, except it's a dungeon light. I'm a little impressed in that respect. And then see these numbers here, they're just defaults right now. But we can actually make it so that as you buy them, that's the number you have. So plus, plus, minus, minus, cost, or name. Cost plus minus. Oops, something like that. Okay, so pop. A lot of times you're gonna just kind of right hand through it. Or of course I guess left hand first will hate me. Always put plus minus, I don't know, plus, but more comfortable going right in this area. Don't mind that. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool because I got my little pointer finger. But we won't need that because we can pretty much do everything with just pushies. So okay, let's see if we can make the number go up and down with a couple of buttons. And just kind of get a feel for it. I'll use this type of button, a little plus sign in it. We'll see what we can do. And we'll attach all those pieces together. All right, I'm going to take a quick moment checking what I have. Always good to have backups. Step. It's not maybe perfect, but it is good. So I say command disks and command things. And I think I got all the pieces in there. Oh yeah, I was trying to avoid. That was from earlier. Nothing I don't mind saving. If not, I'll back it. It's good. All right. Let's see what else we can do here. So yeah. Okay. So we can place. We can now rotate through the different objects. All right. And we want plus minus objects on each of those windows. We could technically just have like the arrows. They don't really move. We just have the pane. One of the things I kind of like the idea is you can then turn to any pane. You can move them, but you can turn to any pane and buy it. Not sure if it's a good feature or not. Yeah. It's not hard to change it. So let's just start with just plus and minus. Let's start there. Okay, so the by command pane is like this. We're going to turn that back on so we can see it. It's got other things. We've got an arrow left and an arrow right object. We can just borrow those, copy, paste them in. Except we're going to call them two different things, of course. We'll call it and cell button. Okay. And cell button. Now I already have these set up, and if you look closely, you're not really in the right location. We just gotta start rotating. I'll put them in the middle. Well, that's kind of create an interesting dynamic. What you do just 10 degrees on one. And negative 10 degrees on the other, you just buy and sell, and they're kind of angled. That way you just push out as you go around. You play with that. I don't know if that's what I want. That's kind of neat. So I'm going to go in here, I got this text object here, and I'm going to just call. Which one is this? This is buy, which is on the wrong side. Now look at it. Very right handed. Very American, English, I guess. I don't know about that. And we have, wow, okay. Good character turn. Buy and sell. If you look closer at this, which is, whoop, too close. You can see buy and sell. It actually fits better than I thought for first try. We can make this a little smaller, though. Yes, yes, I'm using arrow. Let's get my other proper text. Match the rest of the game. Yeah. Of course, change things. It's not too bad. Let's do 42. Okay. Bye. Sell. Alright, and we'll just swap them around. Just swap the rotation. One's 10 degrees and one's negative 10. Now these boxes around it are the push sensors that detect that. And of course I don't have anything really set up for that yet. But there's no reason why we can't have the VR button element, which is actually somewhat inside of it. The VR button element and can, instead of right now about going by command disks, it can actually be linked to the pane, the parent pane, and we need some command on it. So we don't have a command on it yet. Right now, no function. Ooh. Well, I'll go ahead and leak it just so we're ready. Save for a moment. So, bye, sell. Good dollar signs on it. Red. Right now, this is prototype stage. Okay. So, buy and sell. You need to call, I'm just call buy and sell on the pane here. Now, there's a variety of ways we can do this, but the point, I guess. Just start. I'll just make a function here called onBuy. It's really a trigger. And so. Okay. Now we can do a lot of little things on this, but we're going to keep it real simple. And right now, let's go ahead and link that up so that so it goes to the. It's not done yet. Sorry guys. Alright, so here is the buy button. There's the cell button. So this is the on by. Alright, so now triggers. Okay. So basically we got the pane, it's kind of the owner of what's in this display. The subclass has the pane by command disk pane. It now receives by and cell events whenever the buttons are pushed. Excuse me. When that occurs, then it will. In this case, I can just send the command disk that we instantiated. Each command disk has a number on it. I have a use up disk. And I have nothing in here that sets numbers. But what I do have is the number mesh is constantly checking to see if the number available to change and it's private. So all I really need to do is say, I just really kind of need a getter setter. It's probably the easiest way to do this. Yeah, let's do that. So just do this public. I'm sorry. Public unavailable, which is an int, get and return unavailable. Oh, actually, I take that back. That's pretty public. Maybe we should keep that private. Wow, you know, I haven't done a setter in a while. Excuse me. Function, just need the format. Okay. Okay. It's value. That's why. Kind of a, I forget that that's a keyword. Okay, and of course I've got to put this inside of that, otherwise it doesn't make any sense. One's a getter, one's a setter. None of them. Yes, I need to probably make this a private. Right now I'm just serializing that field in public state fast and easy way. I need to make it private. I wonder if anybody's using it. Let's see. And all references. Command disk is the only place it's used. So yay! We can just make it private and let's serialize function. Hopefully that won't destroy all my wonderful settings. There, now we have a getter setter, which technically is still a public variable. But I'm gonna keep that option. So num available, you can't actually touch. Num available, you have to touch. I'm going to shorten that down. All right, real simple now. It's kind of stupid, I know, but. And I even have a stupid thing updating all the time and checking. I don't really need to be doing it that way, but yeah. For the moment, it's inefficient, but I'll come back to that. So when the by command is pinged, has a by, we'll make it real simple, and then I can go back to S1. Now I'll sell and subtract 1, and I did that wrong because it's on the disk. Just technically, we can do that. I don't know. Give me some troubles. Shouldn't. Value add one. Do all the work for me. Thank you. Alright. We go back over here. Do a little bit of compiling. Catch up. Okay. Anyway, so the number is already displayed on the tag. So. Increment. Let's see what we got here. I don't really have to do it this way. And, interesting. You know, I forgot to do one thing. I forgot to set this as the, we need to apply this. And then turn it off. Okay. So now we run this. Now all the instantiated panes will be alike. They weren't before. So there we go. And of course, my buttons are wrong. Interesting though is that not as rounded as you would think.
Pretty good.
Okay, so if we buy, my 5 turns into 6. 7, 8. Of course, I didn't put any safeties, so if we run out, we have -1. Yeah, there you go. Flip, rotate around. Do that. It's beautiful. We can still go over here and hit buy. We can sell. So, I mean, I could technically make this a rotate 3 or something, but it might be misleading. We'll look at it. It's actually wanting to have a gesture and a swipe. We still might do that. Do I want these? I want a bunch of those. I want a bunch of these.